Ramadan, oh Ramadan, Ramadan, oh Ramadan, we love you.
The story of the Holy Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Chapter 11, persecution of the believers. The people of Mecca, and especially the Holy Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam's own tribe of the Quraysh, were unhappy with the message of Islam. At first, they just mocked the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam and his followers and called them mad. But more and more people began to believe that there could not be more than one God and that their idols were not God. Such people began to accept Islam. Chief of Mecca began to worry about how the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam's message would affect their daily lives and the power they held over the people in their towns. The chief of Mecca got together to discuss this issue and decided to stop Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam by force. So they began to persecute Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam and his believers. The disbelievers treated Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam and the followers with great cruelty. When they saw them in town, they would verbally abuse them, throw things at them, and hit them. One disciple who was treated very badly was Bilal radiallahu anhu. He was a slave from Abyssinia, which is now known as Ethiopia. He first heard about the message of Islam from another early follower, Amar radiallahu anhu. Told him in Allah's eyes, everyone was equal. This message was life-changing for the slaves who were treated as objects and belonged to someone else. Bilal radiallahu anhu was instantly attracted to the message, and his life was just as important as his master's and his neighbor's lives. Bilal radiallahu anhu accepted Islam quickly. When Bilal radiallahu anhu master heard that he had accepted Islam, he treated him with very cruelly. He would make him lie on the blazing hot sand and pile large hot stones on top of him. He wanted to cause Bilal so much pain that Bilal would say that he no longer believes in one God. But Bilal would never go back to believing in idols, no matter how much they hurt him. He kept repeating over and over again, God is one, God is one. Fellow Muslims felt anguish from Bilal, and even the enemies of Islam was amazed by his strong faith. Some of the early Muslims had earned a lot of wealth from their work. One such Muslim as Umar bin Affan, he would often buy Muslim slaves from their masters and then set them free. In the very early days of Islam, men like Uthman radiallahu anha and Abu Bakr spent almost all of their money for the sake of Islam, and these sacrifices meant far more than the ones that would come later. Assalamu alaikum. Ramadan or